The Cranky Cactus and the Crying Owl. The Cranky Cactus and the Crying Owl did not get along. The owl wanted cuddles and huddles, but the cactus said, "Be gone!" Now Crying Owl sits alone, sobbing in his tree, saying, "Boo hoo hoo, twit twoo, twit twoo, why won't you cuddle me?" The Cranky Cactus was feeling spiky. A sweet embrace was not looking likely. She said, "A cactus is prickly, everybody knows. Don't touch me with your fingers, or your feathers, or your toes. Your beak is sticky, your breath is foul, and your whining sounds like a dying owl." The owl sobbed, "Boo hoo hoo, twit twoo, twit twoo, I'm so lonely, I'm so blue. Boo hoo hoo, twit twoo, twit twoo, what's a poor little owl to do?" The Cranky Cactus rolled her eyes and said, "There's little more that I despise than a feather brain with a crying streak. I wish you'd shut your sticky beak." "Boo hoo hoo, twit twoo, twit twoo, look who's in a grumpy stew. Boo hoo hoo, twit twoo, twit twoo, you're a cranky pants, aren't you?" said the crying owl. And the Cranky Cactus said, "I'm a cactus fool, I stand alone. You won't hear me cry and moan. Cuddling makes me want to run. I've never needed anyone. Boo hoo hoo, twit twoo, twit twoo, well, I'll just fly away from you," said the crying owl. And just as he spread his wings to fly off into the night sky, a deep velvety voice boomed from a tiny ladybug that neither of them had noticed. "Whoa, whoa, whoa," said the ladybug. "I'm a lady Buddha bug. Not everybody wants to hug, but I can help you get along. You don't even have to The Cranky Cactus said, "On your bike. I've no spare change and I know your type." The crying owl started blubbing again, saying, "No one wants to be my friend." The lady Buddha bug said, "Whoa, whoa, whoa. Can we at least give it a go?" The Cranky Cactus raised his spikes. "Well, I'm stuck here. You do what you like. But could you stop Snivels from springing a leak?" The crying owl glared and blew his beak. The lady Buddha bug said, "Okay, cool. I'll give you some tips from my mindfulness school. Take a big breath and close your eyes, then breathe out a great big sigh. Now take another long breath in. Focus on how you feel within. Is it calm and chilled inside, or whizzy and busy like a fairground ride? Sometimes our feelings get the better of us, and we snap and bark and say mean stuff. It's normal sometimes to feel cross, but tell your feelings, I'm the boss. Wave those prickly thoughts goodbye, and if you need to, you can cry. Life is better when we're kind, and breathing's the best way to calm your mind. Now breathe in deeply through your nose like you're smelling a sweet pink rose. Let your breath wash over you like a wave. It might feel funny, but try and be brave. Ball your hands into fists and wriggle your toes. Shrug your shoulders and scrunch your nose. You might feel tingles or a lovely warm glow. Now one more breath, then let it all go. And next time you feel shaken up, like a fizzy drink spilling from a cup, breathing's all you have to do to help you feel as good as new. Inside your mind, just press rewind and think back to a happy time. Hold on to that thought like a cloudless sky and feel safe and calm as you open your eyes. And the strangest thing happened next. The cactus was crying, but why was she vexed? "I'm terribly sorry, crying owl, that I was so grumpy. I was truly foul. I was cross that you have wings to fly away when I'm stuck here each and every day. And because of my spikes, I can't hug anyone. Being this prickly is really no fun." "Oh, boo hoo hoo, twit twoo, twit twoo," said the crying owl. "I'm sorry too. I was driving you around the bend, but maybe we can still be friends?" The Cranky Cactus said, "Good idea, let's give it a go. But I don't think I'll ever be a cuddly cactus, though."